If you are preparing some Friday Arvo snacks, this one is for you. Imagine 2 months eating only what you can forage or hunt. Crispy possum tails, rat or roadkill, anyone? Bay of Plenty hunter and Keeping It Wild YouTube sensation Shay Williamson has done just that recently. For 60 days, Shay ate nothing but foraged food and chowed down on some seriously wild meals. And he says putting wallaby and hedgehog on the menu is a great way to tackle the cost of living. He describes the yumminess that is a feed of possum.
It's hard to describe it. I mean, it tastes like possum, but yeah, probably the most closest thing to compare it to would be like chicken. Maybe a little bit, it's a little bit darker, and like any animal you want to cook, the younger ones, you don't want to cook like a 10-year-old possum or anything like that. But no, it's not tough. It's pretty good. You can cook it all different, heaps of different ways. We fry it up and then put it in a slow cooker. That's a pretty good way of doing it.
Wow, you're making it sound like a culinary masterpiece. I mean, what else is on the menu if you are foraging and hunting for everything that you're eating, as you did for 60 days? What were other things on the menu?
All sorts of stuff. The animals were, I tried to focus on animals that are considered pests, so I was eating lots of wallabies and deer and some hedgehogs and possums.
Hang on, yeah. Hedgehog?
Yeah.
What do you do with a hedgehog, Shay?
Oh, they're actually pretty good. I mean, you just take the skin off and they're really nice underneath.
You know, because some people listening will be going, how do you get over that kind of mindset?
Yeah, it's just what we're used to, eh? It's like, I guess we've got all our habits that we're sort of so used to eating particular foods these days that we think anything else is strange. But, I guess it's just you've got to dive in. And once you try it a few times, you realise it's just like any other food.
How do you go with seasonings and you know, like people would chop off an onion or, you know, throw a bit of salt and pepper onto it? What do you do for those sorts of things?
During the challenge, I use wild onions or onion weed that grows on town margins all over the place. And then, for seasoning, I had salt that I rendered down from seawater. So I just got a bucket of seawater and heated it and just evaporated the water. And I got about a cup and a half of salt out of about 15 litres of seawater. So that was really easy.
I imagine you've got to be a little bit careful. I mean, what happens if you're sort of ferreting around and you grab yourself a possum and you don't know that it's been eating some bait or poison?
Yeah, so you have to definitely make sure you know if there's any pesticides laid in an area, you don't harvest anything from it. And the same with harvesting plants. You want to make sure that, you know, if you're getting it from a roadside or something, it hasn't been sprayed. But, yeah, that's all pretty easy information to find out. You can go on Google and search the DOC pesticide summary, and that'll tell you all the areas that pesticides have been laid.
Okay, I have to ask, I'm going to use a phrase that my producer uses. What is the most minging thing that you have eaten?
I don't know. It's what most people would probably consider the worst is a rat or a mouse.
Have you eaten a rat, Shay?
Yeah.
And what can you tell us about that? Tasty or not?
Yeah, no, not bad, yeah.
How does one prepare a rat? Do you crumb it? Do you slow cook it?
I cooked it in a camp oven, so. And then I singed the hair off, so I didn't bother skinning it, and then I put it in a slow cooker and slowly cooked it, and that was really nice. It's a bit like eating a small fish, like a sardine, where if you cook it slowly, you can actually eat the bones as well.
So what does this mean for your grocery bill? Because, you know, a lot of people are hurting with cost of living.
I didn't spend any money on food for those couple of months. But, that's probably a bit extreme for most people. But there's definitely heaps of room there to, harvest wild animals to supplement your diet. And that's often the biggest bill at the grocery shop is meat. So we've got heaps of it running around in New Zealand, and it's, most of it's considered, unwanted. So it's sort of a win-win if you can harvest it and feed your family with it for free.
So how realistic do you think it is? Just to not do it in the same way you did, but maybe do a little bit of this.
Yeah, I think it's really achievable for heaps of people, yeah. I mean, to catch possums, you just need some traps, and they're pretty cheap. You can buy a possum trap for $10. And the cool thing about possums is you can sell the fur too. So you can, if you catch 10 possums, you can make yourself, you could get maybe $70 or $80 for that. And then on top of that, you can feed your family for the week.
What's your go-to dish, please? Can you just tell us what your special dish is?
Crispy possum and crispy possum tails in particular.
Crispy possum tails. That was Shay Williamson, who you can see more of on Keeping It Wild on YouTube, with recipes and all the rest of it. The great part of that interview was the alternative commentary coming from Nona Peltier. It is.